with my love and respects. Today is Youth Day. I'll define youth. That is my message for Youth Day. Please understand. Person who is ready to take the past out of his future is youth. Person who is ready to take his past out of the future means not allow the influence of the past into the future is youth. The fears created by the so-called unpleasant incidents of the past are the greed created by the so-called pleasant incidents of the past should not be the base, should not be the root to build your future. Liberating your future from the greed and fear of the past means having freedom to live your future. That is what I call living enlightenment. If you are ready to take the trace or effect, influence of your past from the future, you are youth, whatever age you may be. If already your past has started influencing your future, even if you are just 20, you are old. Understand? The future should be completely open and available, fresh. When you look in, it should look fresh, alive, vibrant, exciting. Not because of the expectations or the traces, influences of the past. No. Just as a fresh flower. Ready to go into the fresh future. Unfortunately, projecting all the insecurities of the past into the future, human beings feel very secure. When you project all your past into the future, all those insecurities, all those greed, everything, suddenly you feel secured. And you want only that kind of future. I am surprised how the ignorance makes human beings feel insecurity as security and security as insecurity. If your future is clean and fresh, not influenced by the mental setup, the suffered consciousness, understand? Almost all human beings who are not initiated into living enlightenment carry suffered consciousness. Please understand, battered consciousness. So out of that, when you project your future, naturally it is going to be completely disturbed, perverted version of your past greed and past fears. Somehow, human beings feel out of ignorance very comfortable with that perversion, feel very safe, secured. No. Not having perversions about the future, not letting your past fear and greed on the future, having a fresh, clean future is the most secured future. Means your consciousness is so fresh and alive, ready to live anything. That is why I am saying, please understand, only if your consciousness is fresh, ready, alive, excited, you can live. Otherwise, everything else is a deep torture. Nothing but a deep torture. Understand these basic lessons. Just today morning, few birds came to my room and started creating some unique sound. Very unique, not crying or very unique sound. I woke up and I was just listening. What do they mean by that sound? I could see very clearly, with a deep, restful awareness, they were chanting Nirvana Shatkam. Really, I don't know. You may think it's my imagination and all that. I really felt I should call the brahmacharis who are taking care of me and tell them to record the audio thing. But before even I could execute that command, I fell into samadhi, enjoying that. They were chanting so beautifully that if I could record it, you will exactly see that not a single rhythm was missing. When I heard that, I really thought, how can birds be chanting? I saw in their very inner space that very ideas that I don't have family, I don't have bondages, I don't have jati, ashrama, varna, dharma. All those ideas are there in their very inner space. I could see the pure excited consciousness in them. Of course, surely they are not ordinary birds. Some enlightened consciousness living in that form of bird, being in this area, maybe for my presence is great. One of the greatest happening in the planet Earth. Please understand, just because only a few hundred of you are sitting, don't underestimate what is happening here. In the conscious plane, we are the most happening place in the world. See, if you see the plane of economy, Wall Street is the most happening place on the world. If you see the place of power, political power, Capitol Hill is the most happening place on the earth. So for each plane, there is some place in the world, most happening place in the world. I tell you, in the conscious plane, we are the most happening place in the universe. When I declare this kind of great truths, it takes little time for people to understand, but they always understand. Because I did not land with nobody to understand. I already sent at least few millions who will completely imbibe me, at least few billion who will completely understand me. So don't worry. This time I have updated my edition and version and everything. So we are the most happening place in the consciousness. I could see, I'll exactly translate and tell you the inner space. May not be the exact word, but the inner space. Of the bird. The complete, pure, independent feeling. Each soul lands on the planet Earth on its own, and it flows to achieve its fulfillment and the purpose of it is achieving the fulfillment. That's all. Maybe the modern day youth need to understand this one truth, then they will be out of thousands of problems related to marriage and divorce. Vedic marriage is the ultimate solution for this great problem. The oldest problem humanity is facing, still unable to solve, which is called marriage. Understand, both of you are individuals, happened here to achieve the ultimate. Be together with this one motive, one idea, and help each other, support each other for that goal. If you want, create kids who will progress towards that goal. Practically all the marital problems will disappear. I could see in that bird's consciousness, the past is not there at all, is so fresh and alive, I tell you. Keep your inner space fresh and alive and excited to live the future as it comes. I am not saying just take it as it comes, no. When you are fresh, alive, excited, you know how to take it as it comes and you know how to mold when it comes to you. How to take as it comes, how to mold when it comes to you. It's a knack which cannot be expressed by words. It is just knack. Meditation is a knack. The ultimate technical knowledge is a click. When the technical knowledge clicks with you, you catch the knack of the meditation. It is not some straightforward instructions somebody will give and you will sit and roll with that instruction, no. That is why I am telling you, unclutching, you can never learn by videos or by discourses, no. You will have to sit and my words, the excitement in my eyes has to click with you. And you'll have to sit with that click and the knack of unclutching has to happen in you. You have to catch. It's a knack. Life is a knack. Understand? It's an act. Do not allow your past, the greed and fear, inhibitions, shyness, suffering of the past into the future. Today you decide, from today I'll be a youth. Make the decision. I will not allow my past to be projected into the future. I will live as youth. Youth is related to being, not related to body. Just decide to be a youth. You will celebrate your whole life as Youth Day. So my Youth Day message is, decide to be a youth eternally. Nitya Yavanas. Eternal youth. So decide that all of you will be Nitya Yavanas, means eternally young, eternal youth. Just little intelligence, nothing else. Don't allow your past's constant fear and greed, everything into the future. Live with awareness, radiate, be eternal youth. I bless you all to be eternal youth. I bless you all to achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, and share the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.